Hello everybody, the Destroyer here, and welcome back to another cast of the Rise of the Witch King, patch 2.02, version 5.0.1. Today we have a 2v2 on a dune, which is not something I usually find on a 2.02, which is nice. Usually I have to cast 1.08 to get a dune game. But here we are. It doesn't have all the trees and shit, which is a thing. It does have dead trees, I guess. Anyway, let's see who we got today. We have Alexis on Phi, also known as Cam. So I'll be referring to him as Cam just because it's easier for me, as Isengard in the top left, and his partner is Phoenix, who's also known as Sania. I'll just call him Sania since Phoenix, of course, is another person, Caster Phoenix. It's just easier as well. And of course we have the bottom team, Mage Shadow as Goblins, and his partner is also Goblins, Asba. Alright, so two double goblins, so there's going to be a lot of spam, and then we have Angmar and Isengard. So there will be actually a lot of spam from all teams. You'll have the Goblin Warrior spam, of course. You'll have the Thrallmaster spam, and then you will have the Wildmen of Dunland spam. So there's going to be a lot of spam in this game. Very spam-tastic. It'll be fantastic. Let's see what they're doing here. Asba's going for a goblin cave, as you might imagine. We need some goblin warriors out there, going for a second goblin cave. And there's his first battalion of goblin warriors. Looks like Mage Shadow's going for a spider pit. So actually opting to go for spiderlings early. And a goblin cave following suit, so he will get some spam still. We've got two halls of warrior, or Hall of the King's men being put out from Sania. So he will start getting his Gundabads out very quickly. So these goblins are crossing the threshold of Isengard's base. Cam does have some Wildmen of Dunland now. And he's getting a second clan steading. So yeah, they are all opting to go very, very heavily on the troop production. Very early on, which is pretty cool. We should be having a lot of action all over the place, I'd imagine, very soon. Spiderlings will be pretty good. Not only are they fast, they are good against swordsmen, of course. So should do well, and they're also good at harassing resource structures, which is something that the 2.0 team is looking into possibly nerfing, because they are a bit too good at everything, really. And I could agree with that. And they do get the spider venom sacks, of course, when activated. It is not a thing you have to buy anymore, you just activate it. Like the goblin swords, poison swords, or whatever. Poison blades. That's what I'm looking for. Poison blades. Looks like Cam's having to deal with some war-chanted goblins there. We should cut through his wildman pretty easily. Although he has war-chanted his own guys. I'd imagine the goblins will not win this fight. Goblins are just too weak. Even with the war-chant, the wildman should still cut through them. Especially when they have the war-chant. Mage Shadow does have some goblin archers to deal with the Angmar spam here. He also has the spiderlings, of course. Pretty good composition here. Spiderlings and goblin archers. Definitely gonna drive away Angmar. So Mage Shadow has definitely opted for a good strategy, I'd say. And Asba is just continuing with goblin spam. He has no archers of any kind for himself, but he does have three goblin caves that he can continue to spam heavily. Ooh, there's the ring. Killed very, very quickly. Looks like Mage Shadow could claim the ring very, very early on. Interesting. Some spiderlings in Sania's base here. Looks like they will have to retreat though. Not gonna get too much done. He is harassing this building here, and as you see, they actually do pretty good damage. Not only are they super fast, super good against swordsmen, but they are also super good against resource buildings. Which can be a problem, as you might imagine. Looks like Mage Shadow is helping Asba over here defend his base against the Wildmen. The archers are definitely coming in handy, especially the super powered ring ones, although that doesn't actually make a difference if you have a ring on your battalion or not, of course. Cam's still going for Wildmen spam. He could potentially upgrade one of these at some point and start getting some Wildman axe throwers, which are pretty beastly as well. Great for taking out goblins. Axelor just cut through Goblin Warriors pretty quickly. I do actually prefer Goblin or Wildman Axelors as a ranged unit over crossbows. As Isengard, I feel they're a little better. They can also be upgraded with armor and weapons. In this patch, they can have the weapon upgrade, which is new to 5.0.1, which is nice. There's Wild Rudar Pikeman being picked off here. Angmar troops getting swarmed down by goblins. We've got more Wildmans throwing themselves at these Goblin Warriors. These poison blades really do a number on a on anything, really. It's not much, but as you see, that guy is dying. He may actually die to the poison before it wears off. I know it actually wears off right before he dies, but it does actually take away and take a lot of his life off, so it does a fair amount of damage. Looks like Cam is going to lose his furnace here. These War Chant and Goblin Warriors. Nobody's going to be able to save that one. Meanwhile, Cam and Sani are pushing in on Azbut. He does have a fairly sizable army there. They did group up their army and War Chant together, which is always a good idea. You can get two armies for the price of one if you are working with your teammate. Always work with your partner to double War Chant off. Sandy is sending more men down towards May Shadow's base. May Shadow's still going for spiderlings and sitting on one goblin cave. You might want to upgrade to a second goblin cave at some point. Just to get a few more troops out in the field. But his goblin archers are doing great work. You see, they are still alive and they are killing tons of wildmen. Absolutely butchering them. We have spider riders out for Azbut here. That will be very, very useful. Of course, against Wildman, it's going to be fantastic. But of course, against the Angmar, he can easily bring out a battalion of Rudar Spearmen to at least deal with those somewhat. Of course, there will be some pikes out from Cam to try and counter these spider riders. So lots of Wildmen with one battalion of pikes should be pretty effective. One battalion of pikes is usually enough to ward away any cavalry, but if you guys get cut out of position like these pike or these crossbows, then the spider riders will have a field day with you. So you do have to be careful how you position your pikemen. Looks like some goblins from Azbut going into the back of Cam's base here, gonna take out that furnace. Ooh, he almost screwed up there. He did actually kill quite a few. Only lost one. That was not a bad charge through, actually. I thought he was going to run right into the pikes and actually lose that whole battalion, but nope, did not happen. Isengard winning the battle over here, it seems. Azbut switching his spider riders into bow mode to deal a little more damage without having to attack the pikemen directly. So he's trying to bring him down from range. The archer damage isn't great, though, especially against the pikemen, I guess. So it will take a while for the Spider Rider archers to actually take down some pikemen, which is a good thing. Azbut does lose a goblin cave, it looks like, right there. So little damage has been done to his base. Not too much, but just enough. So he is still sitting on two of these Hall of the King's men. He hasn't upgraded either, he's just continuing to spam. Probably for the best. If you don't continue to spam, then you might get overwhelmed by the opponent's spam, so you do have to be careful about that. That is always a thing. And you can tell that May Shadow has the ring because these guys have green banner carriers. You always get like different textures and stuff. Like you'll have blue barrage, you'll have green banners, you'll have different skinned Mumakils if you have the ring. So if you ever see that and you're wondering that is why. I learned that last month or something. What are those? Wildmen of Dunland summon, eh? So, looks like Azbut has got that. He has War Chant and Wildmen of Dunland. 475 command point limit. Looks like he's going to take this Furnace of Cam as well. We have Devastation and War Chant, 7 power points for Cam. 650 on 575 now. He has lost 2 furnaces right there. Lost one of his key ones as well. So Cam's throwing up a third clan setting. And he has upgraded this one, so he can start getting Wildman Axelars if he wanted to. Let's go over here. May Shadow does have Cave Bats, War Chant, and 5 power points and 600 point limit. 300 out of 600. We have Felwind and War Chant and 5 power points for Sanya. And 359 out of 600 command point limit used. So that's update on that so far. It looks like Sanya's getting a third Hall of the King's Men. This one's still level 1. They're all level 1 still. Looks like Angmar has pushed its way into Mayshadow's base here. Begin working away at these goblin caves. Looks like he might take this one down. Which is probably alright, since he was just building it. It wasn't already built. But the thralls do go down, and the battalions are dead. Spider Riders, mass Spider Riders, and Bow Mode is pretty powerful. Can be, at least. Well, they aren't the greatest archers in the world. They do actually pretty good damage, too. Especially these crappy thralls. As you see, they take a ton of damage. The armor is just crappy, so they fall very easily. We should fend off that pretty easily. Meanwhile, Cam is attacking Asba here. And as he's doing the same thing, the Spider Rider, mass Spider Riders with the archers, and then following up with some Goblin Warriors doing their Poison Blades. Pretty effective, seems to be cutting their way through Cam's troops pretty nicely. So that is definitely a viable tactic, I'd say. Doing quite well there. Sandy getting more troops to bring in. Another whole army coming its way towards Mayshadow. Mayshadow sending a battalion in here. Possibly to some harassment. We do have some wildmen back here. Possibly they were dealing with some harassers. Spider Riders moving in to start peppering away at these wildmen here. Actually doing great damage. You can also charge them, like that. Seems you can charge them in bow mode, no less. As he just did there. But here comes a war-chanted army from Angmar. We'll see how that does. It's probably going to do some damage, I'd imagine. As it does lose a Goblin Cave fairly quickly, he does lose his Spider Rider Battalion as well. He's immediately throwing up one of these Spider Hole expansions, as they are pretty good against... helping defend against melee troops. I love having tons of these things. Next, melee armies have a hell of a time getting to your base, as they have to cut through these endless wave of spiderlings, which can be very, very powerful. Meanwhile, we have an army from, I think it's Mayshadows. Looks like he's attacking Sanya here. With his Spider Rider Goblin Warrior spam, of course. Still doing fairly well. Looks like Sanya, or not Sanya, Asba has defended his base. He's taking a few hits here. He is down to one tunnel next to his fortress. Out of 3. So that's not a deal for him. Spider Rider's obviously great for defending off your farms here, though. Of course, he could keep things in his tunnel and then pop them out wherever, but... As goblins, you tend not to need to do so. Like with a whole bunch of spider eyes, they're so fast, you can just walk them over where you need them, really. But sometimes it is good to keep guys in your tunnel, just to pop out to defend your mines, wherever they are, if they're far away. But spider riders, like I said, are just great for helping counter harassing armies. Most of the time, the harassing troops will be some form of swordsman, like a goblin warrior or a Wildman of Dunland or something. So usually it's great for these to go after. Nice run through there, getting those Wildmen and those pikes. There's only 2 pikes in that army, so the Spider Riders didn't take any casualties. Ooh, we got Dark Rangers out from Sanya here now. And he also has Rogash. Mr. Rogaine himself. He'll be quite effective, I'd imagine, against spam. He does have the AoE cleave, so he's very powerful, and it starts to get a leap as well. And he also gets dominate troll, so that'll pretty much negate any trolls use from goblins. If they're planning on using trolls, you definitely don't want to use trolls against Angmar with him out of the field. Trolls are also bad against attack trolls from Mordor because they can do the same thing, dominate troll. It's a very effective thing. It also works on snow trolls and hill trolls, so that's something to keep in mind. It's also bad to have to use hill trolls and snow trolls against Angmar when they have a rogue ash on the field as well. He's just a very good hero, I'd say. Looks like the goblin's being cut down fairly quickly here. The axe throwers and the Dark Rangers should be quite effective at dealing with those. We do have Fuel the Fires for Cam there, which is 80% resources for harvesting trees, which is absolutely incredible. I always go for Fuel the Fires if I can, if I'm going Isengard and I have a lot of trees. Lumber mills are just a great way to make money. Asba, the goblin player in the bottom left, has now got Scavenger and Tainted Land as well, and he's sitting on 3 power points. Scavenger, of course, is always good to get as goblins. Usually one of the first powers you want to go for. Sometimes you'll want to go for a Wildman of Tundland summon, though. It just depends on your situation, really. May Shadow, the other goblin player in the bottom right, also having himself Scavenger, and he has 6 power points remaining, and Cave Bats and Warchant. I'm not sure what he had before. Summon Whites from Sania, or Phoenix. And he will have a Felwind and Warchant as well, and 4 power points remaining. He is pushing in on May Shadow pretty heavily, led by Rogash. He should do quite well here. I'd say May Shadow is starting to be overwhelmed a bit, as Angmar is starting to pick up a bit of steam. Angmar also utilizing his Black Numenoreans. Oh, these Spider Riders might get a huge run through on these. Oh, nope. That's the power of Angmar right there. Damn, Felwind screws your cavalry over every time. And the Spider Riders will be mostly picked off here. Angmar did take a fair amount of casualties, but not too many. And he does have the Whites in the field as well. Space Shadow might be in a bit of trouble. And while Cam pushing aggressively on Asba here, Asba still has lots of Goblin Spider Riders. We do have a Sharku out though from Cam. Sharku is great for dealing with enemy cavalry. Although he's dealing with these all these little Goblin Warriors though. Try and get some levels. Got some Half-Troll Marauders. I would love to see Rogash use his Dominate Troll against these. Just see it utilized. But of course, his Rogash is quite busy in the southeast attacking Mace Shadow, so I don't think that'll happen anytime soon. Mace Shadow has gone for upgrades of some kind. Fire arrows, it seems. That'll be quite useful, I guess. It's great for Goblin Warriors, I guess. And even Spider Riders. If you have a mass amount of Spider Riders and Fire Arrows, of course, not too bad. It does increase the damage, which is always nice. It should do pretty well against these Dark Rangers, I'd say. There's a Wildman summon. That looks like that is from May Shadow. In comes a volley, though. It does kill a lot of them. That is a great thing about Dark Rangers. They do have that volley, or long shot power. I always call it volley every time. We do have a Karsh on the field for Sania as well. Karsh is great for dealing with spam, from what I've heard. He does have all enemy units suffer 33%, minus 33% speed and take slight damage over time. Damage over time is pretty actually beastly against spam units. Look at this. They're just dying just by being next to Karsh. So it makes goblins, or makes Angmar very hard to fight for goblins. That's what I'm trying to get at. So I can start to making words that make sense there. Without stuttering over them. These pikes just standing there, slamming their pikes down on the ground, taunting Asba while they get shot to death. Just a little curious, maybe we should, Cam should probably move his guys. Looks like Asba's going for the Fortress Fire Drake. That should be useful. Fortress Fire Drake is very powerful. So that should come in handy. I'd say Asba's doing quite well. He is under a bit of pressure though. Cam has got a very large force over here in the western side of his base. And he does have Sharku chasing around his spider riders, but other than that, he should be okay. We have the leadership for wargs for Sharku as well. He could potentially make use of that if he brings in wargs. Oh, we have the Blight. Blight being purchased by Sania. Blight is such a devastating power, especially against spam teams that have tons and tons of units. Look at all these whites. It's devastating. I still am in the position this power is a bit too powerful. That's just my opinion. I think at least the radius should be reduced. That's a very large space. As Angmar, you don't really need this large of a space for that, especially if you have Fell Wind. You can combine Fell Wind, that, and then Long Shot, and that kind of trifecta power usually results in a ton of whites. Looks like Mei Shadow has defended his base, though, and he is pushing out towards the north. He's got a horde of goblins moving in towards Sania's base. Sania still has Rogash, of course, level 3, and Karsh level 2 now. Karsh does also get a teleport, so he gets Blink, and then he gets Whisper Death. Inflicts massive damage on a non-undead unit, which would be something that is not in Nazgul, I guess. Really? There's not too many undead units. I guess whites, Nazgul. I can't think of anything else at the moment. Maybe there's something else, but a fellow Karsh, I suppose. I guess he's a white, if you think about it. We still have Hwaldar out on the field. Obviously great for his Hillman leadership and his summon Hillman ability. And of course you get money for kills from Hillman. Snowbind throw down on one of these mills to save it, causing the goblins to go elsewhere while being chased off by some wildmen. Ooh, we had a worm summon. I didn't see that, but it did manage to actually take one of the clan steadings. So that's the thing. So far it's very back and forth. Very good game so far. Very heavy, heavy on the spam, of course, like I said it would be. Lurtz is now on the field. He's level 1 though, so he has just been brought out. Would like to see Saruman get brought out eventually, and of course Sauron, maybe Sauron will be purchased at some point. He is goblins. He is a Mei Shadow, of course. Mei Shadow has nowhere near the amount of money needed to summon Sauron. He won't really have a chance to save up for Sauron, that's the problem. While he does get resources for kills, he has to keep spending those resources to keep from being overwhelmed by Angmar. As you see here, he's just constantly spamming troops. That's what you have to do with goblins. You have the Fire Drake out. Fire Drake should do some damage, but he does have to be careful. The heroes will take the Fire Drake out pretty quickly. But it did manage to kill off a lot of guys. The Spider Eye is doing a lot of damage as well. The Watcher somewhere. Where is it? There it is. Watcher being summoned down by Cam to try and nullify some of these Spider Riders. Did actually manage to kill quite a few of them. Rogash still being a boss, clearing his way through these guys. I should really start using Karsh more often when I play. Zangmar, Karsh seems pretty good against spam. Very good, in fact. I'd say he'd probably be your first hero as against goblins. Or maybe or Mordor, even. Hwaldar is always a good choice, too. Wargamir is not a bad choice either, but against a spam team, I think Karsh is pretty effective. That damage over time is beastly. And of course, you do get the unit slow as well. Minus 33% movement speed is quite a bit. They won't be running past you. Spider-Drake doing massive amounts of damage. But we'll be picked off by these war-chained axe throwers, and it does go down. So Azba will lose his Fire-Drake. Maybe he'll get another one soon. He's immediately recruiting it back. Can't blame him for that. Fire-Drake is quite the weapon. And Darkness is out on the field now. Let's see who he casted that one. Mei Shadow, the goblin player in the right, bottom right, has casted Darkness. So his team will get the Darkness buff, of course. Let's actually take a look at the other team's power points here. We've already seen Sania's. He has 10 power points remaining. Mei Shadow's we just looked at. Of course, we had the Worm for Azba, which we saw used. And he does have 18 power points remaining. So he is going for a 25. Worm is a 15, of course. And then we hit the Watcher from Cam, who also has 10 power points remaining. He has all three of his economic ones as well. He also has Vision of the Palantir. So he can't actually see what's going on in an enemy's base, which is always useful. Always nice to know where your opponent is and what they're doing. Darkness. I like the darkness effect, that little orange like glow that your units get. Almost makes them look like they're on fire, but not quite. It's like a super leadership buff. It just looks cool. And against the darkened plane, it looks nice. Progression Karsh and Wildart still leading the charge down here. Forsania is doing it quite well. He does have the Hillman summon as well. Can't tell if that's on cooldown or not. Possibly. Looks like it's just about off cooldown if it's not. But he can use the summon Hillman to summon a few battalions. Rogash does have leap. He is level 6. I actually don't think Rogash needs to be an aggressive. Yeah, there you go. Rogash against Goblin Warriors doesn't really need to be an aggressive stance. Because he's going to one-shot all of them anyway. I'm quick to point out when heroes are not supposed to be an aggressive stance. I mean, there's a lot going on. I can understand why people forget to switch their stances. Spiredrake will go down. Oh no, he actually gets away. Barely though. Oh, it is taken out. Only just. Lurtz is level 5 now. He is giving leadership to his troops. Ooh. Luckily, Asba moved his troops just in time to get out of the way of this Wizard's Tower lightning strike there. Although managing to run back into it while retreating. Big mistake there. How did he not see that, I wonder? We do have a fire Balrog. I'm trying to find it. I'd imagine it's near someone's base. Where? It's here somewhere. I'm not just hearing things, right? There is a Balrog on the field somewhere. Well, I'm not seeing it. Let's see who actually summoned it. Asba, so it will be up in the top somewhere. There it is. Never has it been so hard to find a Balrog. There it is indeed, though. I should get a nice fire breath off here. Looks like he's having issues casting his fire breath. I know how that is. Oh, Balrog. You're so silly. Yeah, if you don't click, like, if you click too close to the structures, he will actually get too close and then not breathe the fire, or breathe in a different direction. It can be a real pain in the ass when you're trying to use his fire breath. Looks like he will get some damage done, though. At least get the leveled up clan setting. He might even be able to breathe fire. Looks like he's just gonna melee it to death. You really should use Ignite, though. Ignite makes things go faster. A lot. Balrog does go down. He did do some damage, though. And he is also raiding the back of Wildman. And while Asba's base is being under attack, there is a Drogoth out in the field for Asba, though. So Cam will have to contend with that. He does have lots of Axors, though. Axors are great. Axors are definitely what you need to counter Drogoth. And of course, Lurks can go into bow mode when he needs to, when he's not using Carnage. You have some hill trolls out in the field. Very tanky, very excellent pikemen. So they'll be helping out against goblins. Ooh, somebody else using darkness here. Let's see who it is. It is. Oh, it's Mayshadow again. It's actually cooled down. Sania almost has 25 power points. I believe Blight is a 15, so he will have a 25 power very quickly here. Shade of the Wolf or Avalanche, I can't remember which. As usual, never remember, never forget. He actually purchased Summon Orcs. He got 25 and purchased Summon Orcs. I guess he felt that was more useful. He is getting power points quite quickly though, so he could be very correct on that. He did Summon Orcs in Asba's base. Sounds like we do have a dragon back here. So Cam summoning a dragon, also using the Freezing Rain. Unless that was Angmar. Angmar used Freezing Rain, so Sani using that. repositioning his dragon over in Mayshadow's base to do some damage. Get rid of the spider pit. The spider pit's definitely key there. It does actually burn it away as well. Nice. Dragon is very good against a base. Not against the fortress itself, but against everything else. Pretty effective. I did hear a watcher. I don't know where it is. We do have a fire drake up in the north here. Dragon continuing to burn away Mayshadow's base. Things are looking bad for the southern team, I'd say. Angmar starting to gain ground against Mayshadow quite fiercely. And of course, the dragon doesn't help. That's going to cut the spam down from Mayshadow pretty much to just two goblin caves, which is not enough to stop the Angmar spam. He will be completely overwhelmed, although there is a Drogoth going to be picked off by these Dark Rangers. He did make a mistake of sending him in there and actually not attacking the Dark Rangers. If anything, he should have attacked that. The Worm being summoned out, trying to deal with some of these guys. This Worm does belong to, who, I wonder? Asba. So we'll be chasing off Cam's units here. Cam retreating. He does have the golden armor upgrades on the Wildman. It does look a little strange, the golden armor upgrade on the Hillman, but it works. At least you can tell they have armor, which is really all you need to know. These guys always look like they have armor, but I'm pretty sure they do, actually. I wish the armor wasn't gold for enemy teams. It should really be, like, a different color. I think that'd be pretty cool. Like, maybe a darker, like, glowing black. Glowing black? I don't know how you do that, but something like that, you know? Maybe a really dark blue or dark red armor or something. I don't know. We have a Witch King out for Sanea here. Witch King, of course, is an amazing hero. You should be able to deal with the... Well, actually, I'd say the Fire Drake might actually be able to kill the Witch King. He's going to use Inferno on him as well, so the Witch King will be standing fire. It does a terrible amount of damage to the Witch King. Look at that. Witch King, of course, is one of the nine Nazgul who are weak to fire. He does need to be careful. We'll have to retreat there. So Fire Drake, definitely a great counter against the Witch King. In case you were wondering. And that, of course, is Asba's Fire Drake. I don't think Mayshadow has a Fire Drake yet. Oh, he does. Maybe it is a... That is actually Mayshadow's Fire Drake. Asba's Fire Drake is elsewhere. Mayshadow sending in his Spider Riders to help his partner out here. He's definitely under siege by Angmar and Isengard here. Mostly Angmar, though. Isengard has retreated back a bit. There's the red glow from the Forge Blades upgrades. Oh no, Hillman there. How do you like that? I think that was a good change. I think giving the Hillman actual upgradable Forge Blades is nice. As Isengard really needed the anti-air. I always thought Isengard has been weak against has had weak anti-air. That's what I'm trying to say. So that's a nice change. It's also great against, of course, regular units. As you might imagine, Witch King's still in very low life. He does need to be a bit careful. I mean, he should be fine against these. Goblin warriors and such. Definitely a hard-fought battle, though. But I'd say the northern team has definitely been getting the better of the exchanges, mostly. Mayshadow's base is fully operational again, though. He is by no means down or out. And actually, I'd say if you look at the mini-map, Angmar doesn't have much. They have lots of heroes, but other than that, they have this small army here. Meanwhile, goblins can pump out a huge army with the amount of stuff they have, and they do have fire drakes. There's a summon wildman. Asba there, he will be tanking the damage while his archers fire away at these buffed up Isengard troops from Cam here. Fire Drake has been recruited once again. Drogoth also back on the field. 5, and he does use his fireball. Pretty effective there. Devastation going off, taking some trees. If you do have devastation, you always want to take the opponent's trees first. That keeps any lumber mills going up that'll do anything. See, this Mayshadow lumber mill is not going to get anything now that he's taken all the trees in the area. The lumber guys will be homeless and jobless We'll have to walk way elsewhere to actually get a tree. Probably, like, over here. Which is pretty far for a guy, because he doesn't actually get the money until he comes back with it. So you actually are slowing the economy down of your opponent if you can do that. That's a good thing to keep in mind. Biggest change for Goblins and Isengard. Isengard having a very powerful army. He's got the very tanky, very upgraded Uruk's pikes, and then he has the upgraded axe swords, which are also amazing. This is the army composition pretty much you want late game for Isengard. This is just really, really good. You get the pikes covering cavalry, and then you have them covering everything else. And of course, axe swords are actually really, really good against structures, which is another thing that makes them better than crossbows. There is that, though. Drogoth still, if he targets them down, can kill them. And he does just that pretty easily. This army back here is going to be pretty in trouble from Drogoth. Drogoth's going to get a nice crunch in on this. Oh, he's actually going to go Fireflight. Sending his little fiery dragon down. Well, I've been trying to kill him. Doesn't manage to do so, though. Drogoth is just so powerful. And of course, he will pick off this next battalion here, easily killing him off. And Drogoth will be quite alive for quite a while, I'd imagine. So even though they have good anti-air, I mean, they still lose their guys. You need a lot of crossbows and axe swords to actually deal with the Drogoth still. It also helps having Saruman and Lurts in bow mode, and Saruman's fireball also hits Drogoth. So that's useful. Got a Balrog over here, summoned under the Giants of the Goblins. I'm guessing this is it's May Shadows. This must be the Summon Giants from Sanya, Mar player, of course. Goblins do need to get rid of those Giants. He has lost half of his production buildings, so he is in a bit of trouble. He doesn't have a whole lot in the way of things that can counter Mountain Giants either. Spider Riders are not great. Of course, Balrog taking a lot of damage from these ice upgraded arrows from the Dark Rangers. They do more damage against Balrog because he's weak to ice, not the fire. So they are the one team that's actually really good against fire things, of course, because they utilize ice. Karsh actually being picked off by the Spiderling Summon, doing quite a bit of damage. These are pretty powerful, actually. They do great damage against structures as well. So they're a nice thing to have. Isengard pushing in once again. Cam looking to do some damage. Summoning the Watcher right under the spider rings. Jesus. My words. Where have they gone? Spider Riders. And we'll begin taking out some buildings as well. Watcher, of course, when he's close to structures. We'll start whipping them. There we go. That Goblin Cave will take some damage. Sanya still has a pretty powerful army. Of course, he does have the Witch King, he still has Rogash. And I think he might still have Waldar somewhere. Hard to tell, really. There he is. Waldar level 9 as well. So he can almost summon a great amount of Hillmen or whatever. Witch King looking to take out some goblins here. Try and save his farm, but he's not going to make it. Too many goblins. Oh, nice. May Shadows actually saved up for Sauron. Possibly his teammates might have sent him money as well. It's possible. He's got Sauron. Sauron casts darkness on the map when he comes out, of course. Unfortunately... Wait. They have darkness. They do not. Okay, never mind. Oh, that's brutal. Absolutely obliterating Angmar's army. The fires of doom from Sauron. Sauron's such a beast. Always very scary indeed. And he does cast a darkness out in the field when he comes out, like I was saying. Hopefully something similar will be implemented when Galadriel comes out. Because as of now, she doesn't do anything, which is kind of odd they would make that change before giving one to Galadriel. Obviously giving a benefit to the evil teams when they get the ring, more so than the good teams. It's a bit of a curiosity in my opinion. Has been doing a ton of damage to Cam's base, though, taking out all his key buildings there. He will be having to rebuild all his clan settings, of course. And Worm being summoned in, taking out a lot of Axlers. This is a lot of Axlers. Drogoth definitely has something to be scared of there, although they could still be hit by a giant fire flight. Where's Sauron? Where's the man, the legend? I guess he's not a man. Oh, Sauron's about to kick some ass. He's going to be difficult to stop. Of course, he does have his terrible fury, which causes fear. He is not invincible, though. As you see, he's taking a fair amount of damage, but these do need to be very careful. K-Bat's also weakening them. They'd be doing more damage if K-Bats were not above them. Sania still has this army here, picking off some goblins from Mayshadow as they pass by, who are still under their darkness effect. There's a drake here from Asba as well, looking to do a little economic damage to Cam here. Meanwhile, the Spider Rider is being sent in to try and do some damage. Trying to crunch a few guys here and there. Looks like I already missed that. That was a delayed volley. Long shot. Ah, I almost got it. Arrow volley is the damn power. I'll never remember, I swear. It's too bad. But at least by this point, if you've been watching me for long enough, you know what I'm talking about. So that's good. I'd say the goblins are losing a bit of ground, but they do have Sauron, so it's hard to say. Things could be fine. Looks like Mayshadow's actually built a lot of his production structures away from his fortress, which is a smart idea, actually, because now his base will be a little bit safer against huge powers that just take a lot of structures, or maybe giants or whatever. We do have two fire drakes over here, of course. They should be doing pretty well. We do have some troll stone throwers, which are going to be taken out pretty quickly by these goblin warriors, as there is no defense to these things, so they won't get too much done. And they're doing very little damage to the fortress anyway. Ooh, Felwyn being used to kill the fire drake, sending him flying, and they are able to take him down. Sauron's taken very little damage, and he's killed lots of men. Fortunately, he's very slow. Since he's so badass, he does not run anywhere. He's kind of like Jason Voorhees, as he just walks around everywhere and somehow manages to get kills. Of course, if you don't know who Jason Voorhees is, Jason from the old horror films from the late 80s. Early 90s, whatever. And possibly the 2000s of the terrible ones. I don't count those. Jason vs. Freddy or whatever that shit is. Ugh. No thank you. Got some wildmen spam here still. They're still doing a lot of damage. The actual wildmen being summoned in on top of them, though. Should do a fair amount of damage. Although these guys are war-chanted, and they are upgraded, so these wildmen should fall pretty quickly. Especially to these Axlors. Axlors just absolutely obliterate these wildmen summon. Witch King picking on the laborers. You definitely don't want to be a part of the Orc Laborer Union. They are not treated well. Sauron's still over here. He does have another Fires of Doom. There it is. Huge, and the Witch King has taken a huge amount of damage. He may actually die running through the fire. No, he does manage to get away. Sauron will retreat, though, as he is by himself. Rogash looking to do some damage to Sauron with his Rage of the North. 100% damage and armor. Sauron taking flanking damage now, which is not great. Rogash is not going to chase, as he is going too deep into the enemy territory there. Cam pushing in with his Isengard troops on the side here. Although he's being engaged by some spider riders and spider warriors, yeah. Goblin warriors, rather. Fire Drake being brought in to deal with some of these. Of course, he's excellent. Does a lot of damage to heavily armored troops. Doesn't matter if they got armor or not, they're going to burn regardless. So Fire Drake's always useful. Late game, you always want to use Fire Drakes as goblins, I'd imagine. I wouldn't see why you wouldn't. How's the base over here looking? Ah, he does have the smog model. Cool. I think that's because he has the ring. This is undoubtedly May Shadows. Yep. Like I said, when you have the ring, you get different textures for your units and stuff. He does actually burn his Goblin Warrior Battalion there. Smog will continue to burn away this building here. Taking another nice mill, getting an actual level 3 Hall of the King's Men as well. And I guess the dragon will despawn there, unless he's repositioning. I think he despawned though. But he did do some damage to Sania's base. Ah, he did reposition actually. So he's down here. Trying to take out Shade of the Wolf with the dragon. And as you see, Shade of the Wolf takes so much damage from the dragon, it's ridiculous. Shade of the Wolf being forced to run, he needs to feast. He wants to survive. Balrog being summoned in. God, this is a hell of a place right now. This might make a nice, thumbnail. But it looks like the bottom team is actually giving up. Asba has deleted his fortress and most of his buildings there. As I guess they have felt the pressure. Which is unfortunate because they were doing pretty well. But eventually players do crack. Not do crack, they're not doing crack. But I mean, crack under the pressure sometimes, eh? Let me just call the pack there. And it looks like Asba will be finished off here shortly. Before fire whipping himself a Shade of the Wolf, though. I don't think he actually needed to quit out of the game. Oh, he hasn't quit out of the game, but he didn't really need to destroy his stuff, I don't think. They have Sauron, they got Balrogs and such. But really, it is kind of a stalemate if you think about it. Although I'd say Sania was actually taking a fair amount of damage. So possibly this was a bit early for surrender. What on earth was that? Probably the Shade of the Wolf despawning, I guess. The Wizard Tower actually is able to hit all the way over here. And while we did see Asba destroy his structures, it doesn't look like he's actually quitting out of the game, which is kind of curious. I mean, he did destroy his structures, right? I'm not just making that up. It looked like he demolished like 3 of his buildings in a row. Didn't look like his enemy did that, so I don't know. I don't know what's going on. He did that, but he's still in the game, so I'm not sure why. Usually if you're going to destroy your stuff, you just quit out of the game. But I guess not. Well, Mage Shadow's still continuing to harass, trying his damnedest to kill his opponent. Although he does have a dragon in his base. He does not look like Smog, as you see there. I do like the Smog texture a bit better than this one. But this one's still pretty cool. I've always liked this dragon texture. But the Smog texture looks way better. Looks more Lord of the Ringsy as well, I'd say. Lord of the Ringsy. There's something for you. Looks like Fires of Doom was called down there, actually taking out almost all of Isengard's army. As a Fire Drake Brood as well. But he's down to a single fissure. That's actually dying to some Wildman axe throwers there. This might be the end of Asba. Will they manage to... No, they will actually be picked up by the Fire Drake Brood. As he won't be able to actually destroy the... Oh, he does have some pikemen here. I didn't see those. It's going to be close. Yeah, he actually saves his building rubble. I think that's all that's keeping him alive, is that building rubble. Looks like a long shot was summoned down there. Somewhere. Sharku's level 7. He does have the Man-Eater. Kill a target enemy, restores health to Sharku, and temporarily grants him 50% damage and 100% armor. Pretty nice power. Sharku's actually pretty good for attacking these Fire Drake Broods, as he can chase them down and kill them pretty easily. But yeah, Asba has been defeated, as you see in the top right there. That leaves Mage Shadow all by his lonesome to fight Cam and Sania, which, to be honest, probably not going to go well. He's been having enough issue fighting Sania himself. It's been very stalemate-ish. They've attacked each other, done good damage to both of each other's teams. But I'd say 2-1, probably not going to go well. Especially since Cam has all of those powers. He has this very strong army as well. And in conjunction with Sania's army, it will be impossible to stop. And I think at this point he has actually... Well, he's continuing to make troops, but he's not on the field at least, really. Look at this little industrial complex here, his economic sector. Lots of stuff there. I did hear Drogoth. There he is. Drogoth looking to kill a few guys. He's going to die very quickly to these... Ooh, he actually almost killed all of those Dark Rangers, but he did actually get killed there. At least he took a lot of them with him. The Fire Drake getting killed very quickly as well. Angmar is poised to destroy the goblins once and for all. Especially since the goblins' economy has been utterly crushed here. Well, it's not actually. He has tons of tunnels still. But his little economy corner here has been crushed at least. And of course, Cam is coming in from the west. Going to make things a little more difficult for him. Also has an army up here. Once Cam gets there, things will not look good for him. Sauron giving chase, though. That's always scary. Sauron can do a lot of damage here. I'd imagine that's why Mayshadow hasn't quit out of the game, because he's still playing around with Sauron. Can't blame him for that. I would have done the same. At least I get to hit some guys with Sauron. Play a little baseball. Or tennis. Possibly golf, depending on what you prefer. Prefer calling whatever he's doing. Hell, could be me playing cricket for all I know. I don't know much about cricket, but... Looks like Mayshadow's base is going to fall here very quickly. This is a lot of Axors, and these Mountain Giants will also get the damage in. Looks like he's actually resisting the Giants to start taking out other buildings. Doesn't really need them with this amount of Axors and Pikemen. So Mayshadow does lose his fortress. At least Sauron will get some sort of attack. No, he actually uses his spear, causing Isengard to run. But, unfortunately, it was only a matter of time. Watcher summoned in. Sauron against the Watcher. Most epic of battles. Zoom in. There it is. Fight of the century. The Dark Lord against tentacle rape thing. Sauron does win that fight, of course. And he actually will kill Sauron off before ending the battle. Which is cool. We'll get to see Sauron explode, hopefully. No, Rogash, don't kill him. Sauron will fall there. He actually nets 1,400 resources as well. And boom, he is dead. He explodes in a word of power, if you haven't noticed. Which is kind of cool. There you go, Mayshadow has been defeated, and Sania and Cam are the victors of this game. Very good game. I enjoyed that quite a bit. Very action-packed. Very spam-heavy, very power-heavy. Very good. So yeah. We'll play to those players, we'll play to the victorious team, of course, and I hope you guys enjoyed that, and I will see you in the next cast of the Rise of the Witch King patch 2.2 version 5.0.1. See you next time!